You're wrong. The NBA did more than any other league to impress upon the American sports fan that nothing is more important than winning a championship. Like, that culture started really because Bill Russell was lauded over Wilt Chamberlain. Look at the championships. Who cares what Wilt Chamberlain's numbers are? Because Magic and Bird were competing for the title every year. Because, yes, Michael Jordan's this high-flying act, but can he win a championship? And then how many can he win? And then in order to catch Jordan, you need the league as much as the press, maybe more. I think the press was following the league's lead. That was the story, and more than in any other sport. More than baseball or football, because in the NBA, best of seven series, run your best plays through your best players. The best players affect the outcome more than any other league. You know, the NFL is the coach is what it's about. Major League Baseball, the GM is what it's about. NBA, the players are what it's about. Winning championships is the thing in the NBA. Now, the league makes money, really. The model is this. Yes, we're entertaining you, but the entertainment, the central focus of it is to see which of these teams can be standing in the end. When the dust clears, one team's going to be left standing. It'll be the search for that team is the entertainment. Everything else is the process to there. So for the league to then step in and go, oh, excuse me, our business interests are now superseding your competitive interests is BS. Stephen A., you say it doesn't make any sense for Mark Cuban to say that. How many championships did the Mavs win? If they're load managing, that doesn't make any sense either. The Mavs didn't have championship talent most years. You know what? They do now. They maybe not this year, but they have the nucleus of it, and I'll bet you they give Kristaps Porzingis every chance to stay healthy. If he doesn't, it's because things happen anyway. He's 7'3", all that. But they'll give him his best chance to stay healthy. Michael Jordan. I'm glad you brought him up. Michael Jordan is the freak of all freak athletes in the history of this country and maybe the world. He is the greatest in any sport to ever do it. If you use him as an example and aspire your other players, even other great players, be like Michael Jordan, it ain't going to work for them. He played 82 games every year. He never took plays off. He was a great defensive player every year, the best offensive player who ever lived every year, won the championship every year, and still played those 82 games. Like, there's no other Michael Jordan. That should not be like, well, since he did it, everyone could do it. No, Michael Jordan, Babe Ruth could pitch and hit home runs.
That's not what I'm saying, but go ahead.
Okay, I understand you're saying that's the paradigm. That's what you want to look up to. Sure, but even then, the league was different. Today, teams are asking each player to defend much more than they ever did, to play with more intensity on every possession, to do more things. It is not the same game that even Jordan
that
played.
That is ridiculous.
Listen,
that's
I remember Pat Riley
that's a lie.
Saying, I remember Pat Riley saying in the 90s that in the 80s, we used to say, who do you want to defend? And now in the 90s, we need to defend everyone. The defense, though you could get away with more back then, is more intense now than it used to be.
Can I ask a
Players
question to you?
Players are asked to expend more energy now. Yes.
Are you saying with a straight face on national television that players today play with more intensity and tenacity than they did back in the day? In the 80s
yes.
and 90s? Is that what
more,
you're saying?
There's.
That,
you're thinking
that
of,
is
at,
you,
You're
that is
thinking
insane.
Of playoff basketball back then.
No, you know, I'm not. Max, hold on, wait a minute. You're not the psychologist here. Don't tell me what I'm thinking. I speak fluent English. I know what the hell I'm saying. I'm telling you right now, that is wrong. I'm not alluding to playoffs. I'm saying regular season even. I'm telling you right now, to say that the players today collectively play harder than the players did in the 90s and 80s, what the hell were you watching? That is not true. That
you
is
are,
not true.
The rules
Patently
changes.
False.
The rules changes have resulted in many more threes taken, a style of play that looks less physical. But if you say on a game, on a play-to-play basis, is each player asked to do more now or less now? The answer is more now. So you must manage.
Hold on,
wait.
Now you're being slick. That's a different. I understand your argument that they may be asked to do more because the pace of play has increased, has elevated. The three-point shot has become more prolific since Steph Curry is coming. I got
the
that.
Defending
I'm not disputing
is more
that.
Important.
What I'm trying to say to you, Max, is that in terms of intensity, tenacity, particularly on the defensive side of the ball, considering the one-on-one matchup that you had to go through, considering the weight, the lack of money that existed back then compared to today and how you were shooting for something because you thought that there would be a windfall financially that was incredibly beneficial for you. And back in those days, without those lofty, exorbitant, guaranteed dollars to lean on, even in the event that you stunk and you couldn't get the job done, there was actually more to play for back then.
Hold on. The salaries, in fact, proportional to inflation and what the money could actually buy you back then, were not that much different. People back then were complaining about the exorbitant salaries in the NBA and other leagues.
But to them it was. But to them it was. What I'm saying is to the players, that back in the day, what existed was you had to do X, Y, and Z in order to elevate your level of relevancy. Remember, it wasn't social media back then. You didn't have your own voice. You couldn't market and brand yourself back then the way that you could now. So you had to do more on the court to elevate your cachet.
This is what it comes down to. You take the average energy expended, stopping, starting, explosiveness, the distance traveled, covered in any given play, back and forth. You take the per minute unit of energy expended in the NBA per player is higher now than it used to be. That's why injuries are more prevalent. That's why they have to load manage.
But it is a totally different type of basketball, as Stephen A. alluded to. We got to leave that one there, guys. This topic will not be done. Load management seems to be the subject of this season.
Yeah.
All right, the barbershop.
I've been asked to give a speech in the spring at MIT. Mm-hmm. After listening to Max, I have no idea whatsoever why the hell they've called me to give this speech instead of him. Because half the stuff that was coming out of his mouth, I'm sitting there scratching my head like, what? And if I'm gonna run, could you imagine me speaking to a room full of Maxes? I mean, I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
He speaks their language.
Dal Mori, I don't know what I'm gonna do, bro. I don't know.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.